Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Ritika and this video is the continuation of my last video which I have started on VPC, as I will be showing you the demo of how to create VPC in AWS environment, and we are doing it from the scratch. So if you haven't checked that out, go and check out after this video or before this, so you will be in the continuation. In our last video, we have created the subnet, but we haven't defined that which one was the private or which one is the public. In today's video, we will be assigning one of the subnets to the public and one for the private. And if you like this video and if you feel this video is helpful, please don't forget to click on thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and put that on the comments if you have any questions or any of the topic which you want me to cover up in my future videos. Please do drop them on comments below. I will definitely read your comments, and don't forget to hit on the bell icon so you will be notified whenever I post my videos, because I think I am not regular in my days, because I'm a little bit struggling in managing my time in how and when to post the videos. So if you have any suggestions, please put that on the comments below. I definitely checked out Ali Abdal videos, like how to be productive and how to be on time, and yeah, but still I'm not easily relatable to those tips and tricks, but yeah, I will create my own. And if you want those kinds of tips, like how to manage work and my life and my family and this creating this video for you guys, I'll definitely try to show you that. But let's get started with this. So in my last video, I have created the VPC. Let's click on the VPC, and I have created the subnets, Southeast 2A and 2C, and it's connected to the route table. So if we click on our subnets, if you go on to subnets here, we can see our two of the subnets, and these are the default VPC subnets, the other three. As we have not decided like which one was the public and which one was the private, but the first one was we have assigned in our network diagram, which I have showed you in the last video, that 10.0.1.0/24, we will take that as public subnet. So we'll go on here and we click on actions and hit on edit subnets. So we will hit on enable auto assign public IPv4 addresses and click save. So as we have enabled the auto assigning public IPv4 address on this subnet, so when we deploy our EC2 instance, so that will be publicly accessible and internet access on this subnet. So for that we need the internet gateway. So this one is the default one. Let's create a internet gateway for internet access on subnet. So here we say my internet gateway, and we'll click on create gateway. So now we have created our internet gateway, and we'll assign the subnet to that gateway. It's so easy to create an internet gateway. You just need to give the name and now it's created. But as you can see here, we have state as detached. Because there's no network attached to that gateway. So we'll click on here and we click on attach to VPC, and we'll select our VPC, hit attach internet gateway. So now our VPC is attached to that internet gateway. And if you have noticed, like while attaching the internet gateway to our VPC, there is only one VPC showing, but the default one was not showing because it's already attached to the default gateway. So it means that you can have only one internet gateway per VPC. So this can be a question for your exam. Just keep a note of it. But to get the internet connection, we need it to route out. So we need to go to our route table, and we can see here we have our two route tables here. One is the default and one is the custom When we click on custom route table, we can see here our IP address CIDR, that is 10.0.0.0/16. That's, if we go on subnets association, we can see here two of our subnets which we have created. So we have two here, explicit subnet associations and subnet without explicit associations. And this is our default route. So whenever we create a new subnet, it will be attached to this route table. So if we want to get our internet access, and that will become our public accessible because we have attached our public subnet here. So whenever we create any new subnet, it will be attached in here and it can be a security concern. So for our internet route, we need a new route table. So we go to our route table, we click on create route table. We here my internet route table, and we click our, and we'll attach our VPC in here and click on create route table. So now we have our new route table. So we need to route out to our internet. So we click on here, edit routes, and we'll add route, which will be 0.0.0, and we'll click on internet gateway and attach our internet gateway. Click on save changes. So now we have route to our internet. Click on subnet associations here. We can see here we have explicit subnet association and subnet without explicit association. As you remember that we have created 10.0.1.0/24 as our public subnet. So we click on edit subnet association and we explicitly allow our public subnet to be on this route table and click on save. And we can see here we have now explicit subnet associations and to this route table with this internet gateway attached to it. So this is where we have our web servers attached. So as you have remember on our network diagram, we have web servers on our public subnet, which will be our EC2 instances running on it. So this is the route table we will be using for our public subnet. Go on our route table and we select our default one. And if we go on subnet association, you can see here that we have no longer associated the public subnet here as we have associated that one to our public route table. So this is how we can reduce main route table or the default one from getting accessed from the internet. So now we have to test it if it is working fine or not. So we'll go on our compute EC2, create some of our EC2 instances to attach to these route tables. Click on launch instance. So we'll go here and give our name as my web server. So if we scroll down and we'll select our Linux, Amazon Linux, we'll go for free tier. And if we go down T2 Micro, we'll keep it that. We'll select my key pair 2, and if we move down in our network settings, if you can see there we have our default VPC attached, so we don't want that. So we'll click on edit and we'll select our VPC. And on our subnet, if we remember, we have selected 10.0.1.0/24 as our public subnet. So we'll select that one, and auto assign public IP, we have enabled that one, so it is enabled here. And we create our security group here. We'll say DMC security group. And if we go down here, we'll add some of our, and we'll add a security rule here. We click on HTTP from anywhere. So this is how we can access our EC2 instance. we go down, we go on advanced details, and we will go down here, and we will, and we can attach our bootstrap script in here. We'll take this script, we'll attach in here. What it's doing, like it's updating yum update, install, and then start our script, and we'll start our EC2 instance. Click on, if we just check, double check, okay, yes, we have done it. Free tier, so your first year includes. So as you can see here, we have, in our first year, we have this free tier. 750 of hours of T2 Micro is available, so you can use that as your, and you can learn how to create all these EC2 instances. So click on launch instance, and we need to wait once it's launched. Now the instance state is running and it's still initializing. Just wait for that. I'll stop the video here and we'll wait for get it initialized, and then we'll come back in here. So as you can see, like we have our EC2 instance is running now. Public IPv4 address in here and private IPv4 address. If we click on here, copy IP address, and what it says hello friends dash the script which I have attached to that EC2 instance. It will run this script now, and we get our public access through HTTP. It's not like HTTPS. If you click on open address here, it will go as HTTPS, and we don't have, and we have not enabled our SSL in here, so it will not open. So we have to use our HTTP. So now we have our public instance web server running on our public subnet. So next we will create our database EC2 instance, and we'll assign it to our private subnet and see how it works. And then we'll see that if we can access our database instance from our web instance. So let's go and hit on create instance. I'll say my TP server. And we'll go for our default, we'll scroll down, we'll go for default, we'll select our key pair, and here in the network, we'll select our VPC network settings, and we have to select our private subnet, so we need to get our private subnet here, which was 10.0.2.0/24. And you can see auto assign is disabled in this, and we'll create our security group. We'll create our security group here, my DBSG. Let's get our description, and we'll edit our inbound rule in here. We'll say as if we do HSH and custom, and if we select our, and we'll select HSH, and we'll go here, we'll select our my DMZ security group which we have created before. We'll select that and move forward, advanced settings, we'll leave in here, and we'll click on launch instance. If we click on EC2 dashboard and we go on instances, running instances, and we can see here we have our DB server instance still running, but if we click on it initializing, if we click on it, we can still get the private IPv address back to our instances, and select our web server, click on connect or connect EC2 instance connect. Click on connect, it says connecting. So here we are in our EC2 instance. Say sudo su, we are on root, and we can create our key pair from inside this server. So we will create our key pair in here, my key pair.pem, and we paste our private key in here. So we are I have pasted my private key, and we quit out from here. We'll say ls. You can see my key pair is here now. So we hit here clear. Now we will hit SSH on our DB server. So now we are in our database server. So now we can hit SSH from our web server to our DB server. So this is what we have done in here. So we have connected from our web server to our database server. If you have any questions, please put that on the comments below and let me know. And so let's rewind like what we have done in our today's video. So we have created VPC, and in that we have created route table, subnets, and internet gateway. We have attached one of the route table to our private and one for the public, and we have associated the respective subnets to our route tables, which is one is public and one is private. And in our public and private subnet, we have created two EC2 instances, and we are now able to connect to our public sub web server EC2 instance from our internet, and from there we can access to our database server via SSH. So that was our video on VPC. If you found this helpful and if you like this video, please put that on the comments, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit on like button and click on the notification bell for more AWS and network related videos. So if you want to know in detail how to create EC2 instance, and you can go and check out my EC2 video here. So see you next video. Bye bye.